Former President Jacob Zuma will not appear in person during court proceedings in connection with his arms deal corruption matter tomorrow. This follows his hospitalization due to an undisclosed medical condition. The Pietermaritzburg High Court has asked for an affidavit from Zuma's lawyers regarding the state of his health.
Another postponement in the Zuma case, this time due to the former president falling ill just a week before yet another court appearance. Tuesday was meant to be Zuma's opportunity to defend Billy Downer's record as a prosecutor.
With regards to Mr. Zuma's attempt to have Mr. Downer removed as a prosecutor in the case, we will vigorously argue for their special plea to be dismissed, as we believe it has no merit, because Mr. Downer was designated by the Director of Public Prosecutions in KZN to prosecute in the matter.
But Zuma and Downer will have to wait for another day in court. All parties in the case have written to the court to agree that the postponement application can be heard virtually since Zuma is not well enough to attend court. Judge Goon has requested an affidavit from the doctor treating Zuma to support the postponement application. If there is a further request for postponement, the treating doctor will have to testify in court as to the reasons for this. While Zuma's lawyers and the foundation have not revealed the nature of his illness, the foundation spokesman suggested that his imprisonment is affecting Zuma. The parties have yet to agree on the postponement date.
All right, here to talk to us further about this, I'm joined now by Advocate Romeo Nthambeleni of the High Court of South Africa. Advocate, good evening. Thank you very much for your time and joining us tonight here on In Focus. So it's pretty much inevitable that a postponement will be granted. Am I correct in assuming that?
Yeah, good evening, Thabo, to the viewers and the listeners as well, and let's say happy Women's Day to all the women in South Africa and across the world. Thank you. You're quite correct to say that there's definitely going to be a postponement due to the reasons that are being advanced by the legal representative of the former presidents, because the Criminal Procedure Act allows the circumstances where the accused might not be present in court in person, and they are raising one of the reasons that are under the provisions of the Criminal Procedure Act as to why the accused will not be present in court in person.
Now, what's the difference between appearing in person in the postponement application as opposed to in the special plea matter, where the former president insisted that he wants that to be done in an open court?
Yeah, look, the Criminal Procedure Act makes it peremptory to actually indicate that the accused has to be present in their own case. And in these circumstances, the court has correctly ruled that the accused has to be present, in court, himself in a person of the former president. And now the circumstances has changed. And you can recollect, Shavo, that during the course of the week, we learned of the development that the former president has gone to and a procedure with these doctors to actually check or determine his status of his health. And under the circumstances, maybe they might have determined that it is not proper for him to be present in court. And as I've indicated, that the Criminal Procedure Act indicates that there are circumstances where the accused might not be present in court. The circumstances entails where the accused is sick or where the accused is actually making the proceedings of the court to be unbearable, where the accused is insulting the court or is making the court environment untenable. And under those circumstances, then the court can conduct the proceedings in the absence of the accused person. So these are the circumstances that are at play. And we can once again see that the former president really is a textbook, example for teaching us the advancement of criminal procedure as we are continuing in the processes, because the court had allowed him to be present in confirming his constitutional rights and the provisions of the Criminal Procedure Act.
Right. Now, talk to us then about the process. I mean, the Pietermaritzburg High Court asking for an affidavit from the legal representative of the former president regarding his state of health. Is that in keeping with the normal processes? Is the president being treated fairly there? I mean, is that something that any person appearing before a court and being found now to be in hospital would need to do?
Definitely. No, Thabo. He is being treated fairly. And that is what is required in terms of the Criminal Procedure Act, because you will reckon that he was granted an opportunity to be present in court, to be able to be part of the proceedings in real time. So he has been given an opportunity to advance the reasons of his absence in an affidavit. So there is nothing untoward with the request of an affidavit to put everything in writing as to what are the circumstances and what actually changed in him not being able to be present in court. So he is being treated fairly. He's being treated like any accused person in normal circumstances. So that is a prerequisite that the legal representative has to furnish the relevant information in relation to his status of his health in order to comply with the prerequisite of the Criminal Procedure Act as to his absence before court, so that later on it's not going to be raised as the proceedings being unfair against him.
Yeah. Now let's get into what we will then see tomorrow on that virtual hearing as part of process. My understanding is that former president will not appear at all in that virtual platform, but there'll be legal representation and the lawyers will be arguing essentially.
Yeah, Thabo, you're quite correct. Look, that application is basically on paper. That application wants the recusal of the prosecutor Billy Downer as the lead prosecutor in the proceedings against the former president. So, more or less that process will move on an application that is based on paper. So, it will proceed in his absence, and I don't think that there's really a real necessity of the former president being present in court, because the application is paper-based and it can basically proceed in his absence, because there will be no interchange of instructions that will be required from him in person when the process is being heard on the papers.
Right. Now, as far as the questions around delay, I mean, whether or not this is a delay tactic or whether it is indeed a genuine medical situation that the former president is dealing with, is that something that is within a concern of the court right now?
I think let's give him the benefit of the doubt in favorem libertatis in law. That's what we actually say. Let's give him a benefit of the doubt, given the affidavit that will be submitted by the people that are actually treating him, and given that they are going to submit the detailed affidavit as we have exposed, it will actually indicate the kind of condition that is actually facing in the present moment. And a further delay in this matter doesn't actually benefit him. The matter must come to an end. It must come to its conclusion in entirety. So I believe that the court is going to look into the complete evidence of what is submitted before it and be able to make a determination. And I think at this stage, there's no benefit in him actually delaying the trial any further. It is much more better that the trial proceeds, and then his fate is determined by the courts. It has been quite long, and it has been quite a long process. And I believe that as the foundation has actually indicated, that this is actually taking a toll on his health, on his own health. So I think it is much more better for him to actually deal with this, to be able to deal with the nitty-gritties of the trial itself. And as we are dealing with our antiquated legal system, we need to move into a much more advanced system where the procedures of court will be able to be aligned with what is current in terms of technological advances in the country. So I believe it doesn't benefit him any further to delay the trial. It's better the trial is decided once and for all.
Advocate Romeo Nthambeleni, I appreciate your time and thank you for joining us tonight. Advocate of the High Court there, outlining some of those issues. Meanwhile, the Department of Correctional Services says it's still unclear how long Zuma will remain in hospital. The department spokesperson, Singabako Tulu, says they are awaiting communication from the former president's medical team.